Galaxies are like little islands of matter in a universe full of a lot of empty space. As it turns out, intergalactic space actually has many objects and structures in it. These structures are made out of regular and dark matter, but some are even formed from the absence of matter. In this video, we will cover these objects and structures, and we will discuss the mysterious voids formed from the absence of matter. Watch until the end to see another mysterious object in intergalactic space, which seems to be attracting many nearby galaxies. When galaxies interact with each other, stars and stellar systems can be displaced from their galaxies. These rogue systems might end up orbiting their parent galaxy, but some may be flung even further into intergalactic space. It is also possible that lone rogue planets, black holes, and brown dwarfs may sparsely populate intergalactic space, but these objects are likely to be found much more frequently in galaxies. Life on any planet within a stellar system that has been flung out into intergalactic space would likely survive just fine. These planets might even be much safer out in the intergalactic medium, and they would certainly have amazing views as well. Around our galaxy, there are some larger structures that are hard to see, but nonetheless exist. The Milky Way actually has three rings of stars around it, and these likely come from past galactic interactions. All galaxies have a halo of dark matter, gas, dust, and rogue stars around them as well. In fact, these halos are so large that the halo of our galaxy and the nearby Andromeda galaxy are already colliding, even though the main collision isn't supposed to happen for another 4.5 billion years. These halos are much less dense than their galactic counterparts. There is so much matter in intergalactic space that many galaxies actually seem to be linked by a cosmic web of gas, dust, and presumably the occasional star. These webs usually also contain dark matter. These webs are found between galaxies that are gravitationally bound, and they draw the lines between different clusters, superclusters, and other structures in the universe. It is thought that dark matter is the reason for this shape of the universe, but more research will have to be done, as we still do not understand exactly what dark matter even is. Another structure that lies in intergalactic space is the void. Voids are structures that are defined by their absence of matter. They are large regions of space that appear to have almost no visible galaxies or matter, and form in between the cosmic web. These mysterious formations are believed to have formed from waves oscillating in the early universe. These regions would be an amazing place to conduct research, and would probably provide for a pretty safe home too. Life on any stellar systems in these isolated pockets of the universe wouldn't have to deal with any nearby intergalactic neighbors. Even still, it's likely these voids aren't complete vacuums, and still contain a particle here and there. Some of these voids even have super-isolated galaxies within them. The Great Attractor is a point in intergalactic space that is gravitationally affecting a very large area around it. Many nearby galaxies seem to be drawn towards it, and it seems to be the center of the Laniakea supercluster, which is the supercluster that contains the smaller supercluster that our galaxy is in. The object itself weighs millions of times more than our galaxy, and more research will have to be done to determine what this object or structure is. In fact, This object is moving towards an even more massive supercluster, which our galaxy is also moving towards. The Great Attractor may be a supergalaxy greater than we have ever seen, a tightly knit group of galaxies, or perhaps something else entirely. Only time will tell. Unfortunately, it may be a long time as it lies in an awkward position in space that is hard to observe. As always, thank you for watching. If you're new to the channel, stick around for lots of more content.